everyone, once again welcome to my channel Competitive Maths by Balaji. Yes, we are in the chapter discount and today we are going to part 11 of discount. Okay, yes, next question of the discount chapter, that is 7th one. The successive discount x percent comma y percent and z percent are given on an article marked at k, then equivalent single discount percent will be equal to dash. Yes, we have to find single equivalent discount to these three successive discounts. Moodu varsa discount lo x shatam, comma y shatam, mariyu z shatam laku samanamaina ekaika discount enta? Mariyu naalu options ivvabaddayi solution. Okay. Yes, here we are given three successive discounts x percent comma y percent come and z percent, and we know that formula, that is single equivalent discount to two successive discounts, that is given by the formula x plus y minus xy by 100%. By the part 10 of discount, single equivalent discount to these two successive discounts is x plus y minus xy by 100%. And we have third discount, that is z percent. Let us find single equivalent discount of these two successive discounts now. That is x plus y minus xy by 100 plus z minus x plus y minus xy by 100 into z by 100 percentage. Okay, yes, it is of the form again x percent into y percent, x percent plus y percent minus xy by 100 percent. Again we use this formula, that is called x plus y plus z, x plus y plus z minus xy by 100 minus x into z minus xz by 100 minus into plus minus y into z minus yz by 100 minus into minus plus x into y into z xyz by 100 divided by 100, that is 100 into 100, 10,000 percentage. Just to rearrange the formula, x plus y plus z, so these three terms having negative sign, take it away the negative sign, we get xy plus yz plus zx by 100. Since denominators are equal, LCM is 100. Then add the numerators as it is, that is xy plus yz plus zx plus xyz by 10,000 percentage. That is single equivalent discount to these three successive discounts is given by x plus y plus z minus xy plus yz plus zx plus xyz by 10,000. So answer is minus plus, answer is B. Also, this formula can be rearranged as follows: x plus y plus z denoted by S1 minus xy plus yz plus zx is denoted by S2 over 100 plus xyz is denoted by S3 by 10,000 percentage, where here S1 equals sum of the successive discounts. S1 equal what? Sum of the successive discounts, that is x plus y plus z. Yes, sum of the successive discounts taken one at a time is denoted by
S1 and S2 is equal to, S2 is equal to sum of the successive discounts taken to at a time, taken to at a time, that is written as xy plus yz plus zx. Yes, sum of the successive discounts taken to at a time, that is noted by S2. And S3 called, and S3 called product of the successive discounts, which is equal to x into y into z. So by this formula we can easily remember the single equivalent discount of three successive discounts, that is S1 minus S2 by 100 plus S3 by 10,000, where S1 is sum of the discounts taken one at a time, S2 is sum of the discounts taken two at a time, xy plus yz plus zx, S3 equal product of the successive discount, that is x into y into z. Okay, next questions. Eighth one. Three successive discounts of 15%, 10% and 20% is equivalent to a single discount of dash. 15 శాతం, 10 శాతం మరియు 20 శాతంల మూడు వరుస రాయితీలకు సమానమైన ఏకైక రాయితీ ఎంత? Yes, formula is that S1 minus S2 by 100 plus S3 by 10,000. Percentage is the single equivalent discount to these three successive discounts. Okay. S1, so that is 15%, 10%, 20% is given. S1 is sum of the three discounts. 15 plus 10, 25 plus 20, 45. Minus. S2 is sum of the discounts taken to at a time. Sum of the discounts taken to at a time. 15 tens are 150 plus 10 twenties are 200 plus 20 fifteens are 300 by 100 plus S3. S3 is product of three discounts. 150 into 20, that is 3000 over 10,000. So 3 zeros gets cancelled. 3 to 500 plus 150, 650. 45 minus 650 over 100. 0, 0 cut. 3 by 10 computed as 0.3%. Okay. 45 minus 65 by 10, that is 6.5 plus 0.3%. 45 minus 6.5, that is 38.5 plus 0.3%, that is 38.8% is the answer. So answer is C. Let us see it by digital concept method. Digital concept method. Method 2. Digital concept method. So, net discount. So, net discount is equal. That is, single equivalent discount is always equal to market price minus selling price. Market price minus selling price. Suppose, let us suppose market price be 100. Then selling price is, since 15% is discount, so remaining selling price is 85% of market price 100. But 85% can be written as 0.85. Again, this is reduced price of the article. Again, we given 10% discount. So, article is sold at 90% of this reduced amount. 90% is nothing but 0.9. This is the second reduced price of the article. Again, we allow 20% discount. 20% discount means for every 100 it is 20 less. So article is sold at only 80% of this reduced price. 80% nothing but 0.8. Okay. Let us use digital sum concept. Digital sum, that is sum of the digits. 1 plus 0 plus 0, 1 minus. See, it is digital sum is 8. Digital sum is 9. 8 plus 5, 13. 13, 1 plus 3, 4, digital sum. 0 plus 0 plus 1, 1. Again, 9, 4 is 36. 36 means 3 plus 6, 9. 9, 8 is 72. 7 plus 2, 9. Since digital sum 9 or 0, both are equal. Okay. Digital sum is 9 or digital sum is 0. Both are equal in the digital sum concept. So, we use only 0 here. 1 minus 0. Answer digital sum must be 1. Consider the digital sum of options. Sum of the digits. 2 plus 2, 4 plus 4, 8. So, it is not answer. 5 plus 4, leave the 9. 9 or 0. Digital sum 9 or 0. Both are equal. So, 5 plus 4, 9 or digital sum 0. 3 is the digital sum. Now, 8 plus 8, 16. 16 plus 3, 19. 9 plus 1, 10. 10 means digital sum is 1. It may be answer. 5, 4, leave the 9 when we are finding digital sum. That means 9 or 0 are equal. So, digital sum is 4. So, answer is C. That is equal to 38.8%. Single equivalent discount to these three successive discounts. Okay. Yes. Three successive discounts, 20%, 25% and 18% is equivalent to a single discount of 20%, 25%, 18% la moodu varsa raayithulaku samanamaina ekaika raayithi anta. Ikkada kuda manamu digital sum concept upayogindam. Let us use digital sum concept. Net effective discount or single equivalent discount is always the difference of market price and selling price. Suppose market price be 100, then what is selling price? Selling price is initially he given 20% discount. So article is sold at 80% of 100, that is market price. 80% nothing but 0.8. Yes, 80% nothing but what? 0.8. This is reduced price. On this reduced price, again he allowed 25% discount. 25% discount means for every 100, it reduced to 25. So, article is sold at 75%. That can be written as 0.75 times of reduced price. This is the second reduced price of the article. Again, he allowed 18% discount. That means for every 100, it is 18 rupees less. So, article is sold at only 82%, that is 0.82. So, selling price is 0.82 into 0.75 into 0.8 times of market price 100. Digital sum is 1 here and digital sum is 1875. 12, 12 means 2 plus 1, 3. 8 plus 2, 10. Digital sum is 1. Since we have the product symbol again, 8 threes are 24. 24 is the product. 2 plus 4, 6 is digital sum. 6 is digital sum. So, here we can write digital sum 1 or 10, both are equal. Digital sum 1 or 10, both are equal. Digital sum 9 or 0, both are equal. 10 minus 6, digital sum is 4. So, answer digital sum must be 4. See here, 5 plus 4, 9, leave. Digital sum is 8, so it is not answer. 4 plus 4, 8, digital sum is not 4. 8 plus 5, 13, 13, 1 plus 3, digital sum 4, it may be answer. 5 plus 6, 11, 11, 1 plus 1, 2, digital sum, so it is not answer. So, answer is only C, 50.8% is the single equivalent discount of these three successive discounts. Okay, students, next questions, 10th one. A single discount equivalent to three successive discounts of 22 whole 2x9%, 14 whole 2x7% and 6.25% is. This time, percentages are very typical. we cannot use formula here. Okay, yes, we use ratio method. We use ratio method here to solve these type of problems. 22 పూర్ణాంకం 2/9%, 14 పూర్ణాంకం 2/7% మరియు 6.25% ల మూడు రాయితీలకు సమానమైన ఏకైక రాయితీ ఎంత? ఇప్పుడు పర్సంటేజ్ చాలా టిపికల్ గా ఇచ్చాడు, ఫ్రాక్షన్స్ డెసిమల్స్ ఇచ్చాడు. ఇక్కడ మనం ఫార్ములాను ఉపయోగించలేము, S1 minus S2 by 100 plus S3 by 10,000 అనే ఫార్ములాను ఉపయోగించలేము. మరి పర్సంటేజెస్ ఇలా టిపికల్ ఉన్నప్పుడు మనము నిష్పత్తి పద్ధతిని ఉపయోగిస్తాం. అదేందో చూద్దాం. 22 whole 2/9%, ఫ్రాక్షన్ వాల్యూ ఇస్ 2/9, అండ్ 14 whole 2/7%, ఫ్రాక్షన్ వాల్యూ ఇస్ 1/7, 6.25%, ఫ్రాక్షన్ వాల్యూ ఇస్ 1/16. ఓకే, ఈ పర్సంటేజ్ యొక్క ఫ్రాక్షన్ వాల్యూ 2/9, ఈ పర్సంటేజ్ యొక్క ఫ్రాక్షన్ వాల్యూ 1/7, 6.25% 1/16. ఇప్పటికీ పర్సంటేజెస్ ని భిన్న రూపంలో ఎలా రాస్తున్నామో ఎవరికైనా అర్థం కాకుండా ఉంటే పర్సంటేజ్ ఫస్ట్ చాప్టర్ పర్సంటేజ్ ఫస్ట్ సెకండ్ క్లాస్ ని వినండి. ఓకే, ఎస్, ఈచ్ టైమ్ వి ఆర్ కన్సిడర్ రేషియో ఆఫ్ మార్కెట్ ప్రైస్ టు సెల్లింగ్ ప్రైస్ హియర్. సిన్స్ దీస్ త్రీ ఆర్ డిస్కౌంట్, డిస్కౌంట్ ఈస్ ఆల్వేస్ అలౌడ్ ఆన్ మార్కెట్ ప్రైస్, సో డినామినేటర్ మార్కెట్ ప్రైస్. ఇఫ్ మార్కెట్ ప్రైస్ ఆఫ్ ది ఆర్టికల్ ఇస్ 9, 2 యూనిట్స్ ఆఫ్ డిస్కౌంట్, సో 7 యూనిట్స్ ఆఫ్ సెల్లింగ్ ప్రైస్. సిమిలర్లీ ఇఫ్ మార్కెట్ ప్రైస్ ఆఫ్ ది ఆర్టికల్ ఇస్ 7 యూనిట్స్, 1 యూనిట్ ఇస్ డిస్కౌంట్, సో సెల్లింగ్ ప్రైస్ ఇస్ 6 యూనిట్స్. సిమిలర్లీ ఇఫ్ ద మార్కెట్ ప్రైస్ ఆఫ్ ది ఆర్టికల్ ఇస్ 16 యూనిట్స్, 1 యూనిట్ ఇస్ డిస్కౌంట్, సో సెల్లింగ్ ప్రైస్ ఇస్ 15 యూనిట్స్. నెట్ ఎఫెక్టివ్ రేషియో ఆఫ్ దీస్ త్రీ రేషియోస్ ఈస్ ద రేషియో ఆఫ్ మార్కెట్ ప్రైస్ టు సెల్లింగ్ ప్రైస్. ఓకే, ఎస్, 3 2s are 3, 3s are 3, 5s are 7, 7s are 2, 1s are 2, 8s are. So net ratio is 8 is to 5. That means if market price of the article is 8 units, then selling price is 5 units. So market price is reduced by 3 units over market price 8 units. 1 by 8 nothing but 12.5%. 3 times of 12.5 is 37.5%. Single equivalent discount to these three successive discounts is 37.5%. That is D. 11th one. Three successive discount of 28 whole 4/7%, 25% and 6 whole 2/3% is equal to a single discount of 25 పూర్ణాంకం 4/7%, 25 శాతం మరియు 6 పూర్ణాంకం 2/3% లో మూడు వరుస రాయితీలకు సమానమైన ఏకైక రాయితీ ఎంత? 28 whole 4/7, ఫ్రాక్షన్ వాల్యూ ఇస్ 2/7, 25% మీన్స్ 1/4, 6 whole 2/3 మీన్స్ 1/15. కన్సిడర్ ద రేషియో ఆఫ్ మార్కెట్ ప్రైస్ టు సెల్లింగ్ ప్రైస్ ఈచ్ కేస్. మార్కెట్ ప్రైస్ ఇస్ 7 యూనిట్స్, దెన్ 2 యూనిట్స్ ఇస్ డిస్కౌంట్, సో సెల్లింగ్ ప్రైస్ ఇస్ 5 యూనిట్స్. ఇఫ్ మార్కెట్ ప్రైస్ ఇస్ 4 యూనిట్స్, 1 యూనిట్ ఇస్ డిస్కౌంట్, సెల్లింగ్ ప్రైస్ ఇస్ 3 యూనిట్స్. If market price is 15 units, 1 unit is discount, so selling price is 14 units. 5 3s are 15, 15 gets cancelled. 7 1s are 7, 2s are 2, 1s are 2, 2s are 2 is 1. So if market price is 2 units, selling price is 1 unit. That is market price reduced by 1 unit, discount is 1 unit over 2 units market price. 1 by 2 nothing but 50% is the single equivalent discount of these three successive discounts. So answer is C. Okay students, చూడండి రేషియో మెథడ్ లో క్యాలిక్యులేషన్ ఎంత సింపుల్ గా చేస్తున్నాము. క్యాన్సిలేషన్ క్యాలిక్యులేషన్ మొత్తం రెడ్యూస్ అయిపోతుంది రేషియో మెథడ్ లో. ఓకే, నెక్స్ట్ క్వశ్చన్ 12th one. A shopkeeper normally allows a 10% discount on the market price of each article. During a sale season, he decides to give 2 more discounts. The first being at a rate of 50% of the original. First discount is at a rate of 50% of the original, and the second at a rate of 40% of the first. What is the percentage rate the equivalent single discount correct to two decimal places. Yes. ఒక వ్యాపారి సాధారణంగా 10% రాయితీ ఇస్తాడు. పండగ సేల్ సమయంలో మరో రెండు రాయితీలు అదనంగా ఇవ్వవలెనని నిర్ణయించాడు. వాటిలో మొదటిది అసలు రాయితీలో 50%. అసలు రాయితీ ఎంత? 10%. 10%లో 50% మొదటిది. రెండవది మొదటి రాయితీలో 40%గా ప్రకటించాను. వీటన్నిటికి సమానమైన ఏకైక రాయితీ శాతం ఎంత? Solution, let us suppose original discount is 10%. Original discount is 10%. During the sale season, he decides to give two more discounts. Among the two more discounts, first discount is 50% of the original, that is 10. Two zeros percentage gets cut. 5 is the first discount. And second discount is, and the second at a rate of 40% of the first. First discount is 5. Second discount is 40% of 5. 40 by 100 into 5. 0, 0, 5 ones, 5 twos, 2 ones, 2 twos. That is 2% is the third. So, single equivalent discount of 10%, 5%, 2% is, that is, single equivalent discount is equal 10 plus 5 plus 2 by formula method, that is S1 minus S2 by 100 plus S3 by 10,000%. S1 is sum of the discounts taken one at a time, 10 plus 5, 15 plus 2, 17, minus 10 5s are 50, 5 2s are 10, 50 plus 10, 60, 60 plus 20, 80 by 100, plus product of the discounts, 10 5s are 50, 50 2s are 100, 100 by 10,000%, 2 zeros, 2 zeros gets cut, 0 0 cut, 17 minus 8 by 10 nothing but 0.8, 1 by 10 nothing but 0.1, 1 by 100, 0.01, which is equal 17 minus 0.8, that is 16.2 plus 0.01, which is equal 16.21%. Let us see it by digital sum concept. Digital sum concept. Suppose market price is 100, since single equivalent discount is always equal to market price minus selling price. Suppose market price be 100, then selling price is, since originally he allowed 10% discount, so article is sold at 90% of market price, 90% nothing but 0.9 into, now it is reduced to price, again he allowed 5% discount, so article is sold at 0.95 times of reduced price. Again, he allowed 2% discount, so article is sold at 98%, 98% nothing but 0.98 times. Since in the product we have the digit 9, so its digital sum is 9R0 and its digital sum is 1. 1 minus 0, digital sum 1 minus 0 is 1. Answer digital sum must be 1. Consider the digital sum options 5 to 7, 7, 5. 12 plus 1, 13, distance sum 4, so it is not answer. Leave the 9, 6 plus 3, 9, distance sum is 1. Leave the 9s, 9, 8 plus 1, 9, distance sum is 2. 7 to 9, 3 plus 1, 4, distance sum. So only option B has distance sum 1. So answer is 16.21%. Okay, next last two questions of this class, 13th one. Most important questions these two are. 50 successive discounts of 2%, 4%, 6%, 8% and so on will result in a single discount of 50 వరుస రాయితీలు 2% కమ 4% కమ 6% కమ 8% డాష్ 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 లకు సమానమైన ఏకైక రాయితీ ఎంత? సొల్యూషన్. ఇలాంటి రాయితీలు 8%, 10%, 12% అప్ టు 50 వరుస రాయితీలు ఇచ్చారు. అయినా వీటన్ని 50 వరుస రాయితీలకు సమానమైన ఏకైక రాయితీ ఎంతనో కనుక్కోవాలి. ఎస్, లెట్ అస్ మేక్ ఏ నోట్ పాయింట్. సపోజ్ మార్కెట్ ప్రైస్ ఆఫ్ ది ఆర్టికల్ బి 100, మార్కెట్ ప్రైస్ ఆఫ్ ది ఆర్టికల్ బి 100, దెన్ ఎట్ మోస్ట్ we can give 100% discount. Yes, at most we can give 100% discount. Since market price of the article is 100, suppose let us see an example. So market price of an article is 500 rupees. Market price of the article is 500 rupees. And we told that to the customer, sir, please take it as free. Sir, please take it as free cost. So selling price is what? 0 rupees. So 500 labeled article is sold at 0 rupees. So discount is 500. Discount percent is 500 over 500. Discount is 500 over market price 500. That is one nothing but 100% is discount here. Discount percent is 100%. More than 100%, it is not possible to give the discount. So A and B are not the answers. Okay, since we are given 50 successful discount, so at most the discount is 100%. So answer is C. That's it. Next, 14th one. A company offers 4 types of successive discounts. Which offer is the best for the customer? Important one. ఒక కంపెనీ 4 రకాల రాయితీ ఆఫర్లను ప్రకటించింది. అయినా ఈ క్రింది వానిలో ఏ ఆఫర్ వినియోగదారునికి లాభం చేకూర్చును? అలాగే మనం అనుకుందాం ఏ ఆఫర్ కంపెనీకి లాభం కూడా అనుకుందాం. సో సొల్యూషన్, single equivalent discount of 40% and 10%. That is, we use the formula x plus y minus xy by 100%. Okay, 40 plus 10 50 minus 40 to 10 400 by 100, that is 4. 50 minus 4 means 46% net effect. And here also 40 plus 5 50 minus 45 into 5. 540s are 200, 55s are 25, 225 by 100 percentage. That is 50 minus 2.25, which is equal 47.75%. And third one, 30% and 20%. 30 plus 20, 50 minus 30 into 20, 600 by 100%. 2 zeros, 2 zeros cut, 44%. Next, 35 plus 15, 50. 35, 15, sir. 15, 5s are 75. 15, 3s are 45 plus 7, 52 by 100 percentage, which is equal to 50 minus 5.25, 44.75%. So, which offer is best for the customer? Yes. Since here we get maximum discount 47.75%. So 45% and 5% discounts are the best for the customer. See here, another shortcut method to solve these type of problems. In each option, sum is constant. 40 plus 10, 50. 45 plus 5, 50. 30 plus 20, 50. 35 plus 15, 50. Sum is fixed, which is equal to 50. When sum of 2 successive discounts are fixed, then consider the difference. Difference of 40 and 10, that is 30. Difference of 45 and 5, that is 40. Difference of 30 and 20, 10. Difference of 35 and 15, 20. See, here the difference is maximum. Here the difference is maximum. If the discounts having maximum difference is best for the customer, and see here the difference is minimum here. If the difference is minimum, these two discounts are best for the shopkeeper or company. Okay.